These are the spindles that we had from our barn, and so we're cutting them up into lengths to fit the raised beds, and that's my job. My job is to cut up the spindles that we have saved. We've actually saved these spindles from a barn that collapsed on an old property of ours, and that probably happened about 8 or 9 years ago, and we've been saving these spindles thinking that we would have a purpose for them. Never threw them out, and we've moved them around a couple of times, and now we finally found a purpose for them, and it's worked out really well for these raised beds. So that's what I'm doing. I have to cut 28 of these, and so far I have 4, 8, 12, 16, I have 20, so 8 more to cut. And here's all the wood that we've been storing, and that's the last of the spindles from our barn that we used to have. And we still have quite a bit. I've got the 28 plus pieces that I needed to have cut. And this is the aluminum siding. Underneath all of those aluminum window frames is aluminum siding that we also replaced on a mobile home that we once lived in. So we've been saving that aluminum siding, and we have repurposed that for the raised beds as well. This aluminum siding here, this was left from the chicken coop that we had taken off, and we have repurposed that also to do the raised beds. I have my rhubarb is coming up. And we've put in another compost bin. I mowed the lawn yesterday and the day before, so that's just all grass clippings and in the bag grass clippings. And my husband got a hold of these pallets. He is going to put that together to do another compost bin, and that's mostly going to be for the grass clippings. Under there is another compost pile that we have protected, and that's mostly protected from the chickens because they'll come in there and scratch it all up and flatten the whole pile up. That was our other compost pile that we had, and this is our new compost pile. We've just taken a cattle panel and wrapped it around and layered all of the layers, and that's chicken bedding, manure, leaves, compost, grass, you name it, it goes in it. And there's the girls enjoying the sun. So the aluminum siding that's done on this shorter raised bed with the strawberries in it, that's the aluminum siding that we had from our old trailer that we, I just showed you the pile from that one. Strawberries are doing good now that I've replanted them. And then these raised beds here, that is from the aluminum from the chicken coop that was left over from around this property that we have found. So we have our two short ones. We have all five of the taller ones, the other two short ones, and we're in the midst of building the new U-shaped one. So just building it in place. There's the frames of from the inside frame, and then we'll do the outside frame with those other spindles that I've just cut. And we have treated 2x6s for the tops and the bottoms for the frame. So that's going to go all the way around and across and over to that side. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm putting in one of the panels, cattle panels. I've cut it. It was a 16-foot length, and I cut it into just over 7 feet so that it would fit in this bed. And I'm going to be pounding the T-posts in and then attaching the panel with zap straps. This one I'm not making into an arbor. The panel is just going to be going straight up and down because it's a middle bed, and I'm just doing arbors on the two outside beds. Okay, so now I'm going to put the panel up. I will get my zap straps ready. And maybe I can get my wonderful assistant to come and help me. I want to raise this up anywhere from 18 inches to 2 feet above, and this is what I'm going to be.
Okay, well, use your measuring tape to figure out.
Okay. So that's 1.5. Maybe go up just a little bit higher.
Okay. Holy crap, how tall are your
right
snails?
There.
First.
So that one needs to be a bit higher.
There you want it. If you use your measuring tape, you know for sure. Okay, we need to get them tighter.
Okay.
Yeah, I would put three, dear.
Hey, I will. Thank you. Okay, so get two more. I'm using this fence panel for my indeterminate tomatoes because they can grow anywhere from 10 to 12 feet high. So that is the whole idea of having the fence panel raised up as high as it is. And I will be pruning heavily on the tomatoes itself. They won't have any bottom leaves. That. Bring you over to this one, get a better angle. So there's the other one with the arbor, and that's going to be for squash, like your spaghetti squash, butternut squash, and melons, cucumbers. I wanted to come out and do some planting just because we finally have some of our arbors up and our panels, supports that we wanted to have up in the garden. We finally have some of those up, and I was hoping to get something planted, but I hear thunder, and so I think it's going to be raining pretty quick here, so we'll see how far we get with this. Here's what we've put. Got the arch over there on that bed. We've got just a flat panel on T-posts on that. Then over there we have another arch area supports as well. And then I have another one over on the smaller bed. So these are the beds that I want to be having planted today. Is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to plant. Well, I got rained out. I only got 4 kinds of radishes planted. So, oh well, I mean, and then it was a downpour of rain. And it's still thundering, so there's probably more to be coming. They're calling for rain all day today, all day tomorrow. And so I've decided to feed the pigs their little treats. So in the morning, we feed them just their hog food. And then in the afternoon, I will come out and give them a little treat, and they usually come running when they hear me coming. See how long it takes them to notice me. Well, hi, Sumai. Hi. Hi there, Dumpling. Yeah, over here. Over here. You've got your treats. Got your treats. Some apples. Some tomatoes. Some lettuce. And I think we even have a slice of bread in there too, for some added measure. And then 4 little containers of milk. And they just absolutely love this. And she doesn't want me taking a video of them eating, I think. They're getting big. So we're planning for
the end of July, they're already well over 200 pounds each. And so we're planning at the end of July, so in another just over 2 months. Right now it's May the 17th, and yeah, we're hoping for the end of July to process them. And apples are supposed to be good to help make their meat taste better. So I just keep going to the grocery store and seeing if they have any discontinued fruit bagged up, and I pick it up. And I always try to make sure I always have something. My sister-in-law and my brother-in-law also give us a lot of vegetables and some fruit. They'll give us quite a bit, so the pigs are loving it. And we still have the milk that I got from the school that I work at. So, almost finished eating up the last of the lettuce. All right, girls. Enjoy your treat. So, it's just sprinkling out right now. I just gotta do up this gate. I see that my husband has pulled out some more tin and cut that up. That's probably what he's going to be using for the other raised bed that he has made. I'm going to quickly go over there. It's like just a light drizzle. So I'm going to quickly go over and show you. Oh, there he's pulled out all of this too, because there's quite a bit that he's going to need to do, so he's got that as well. Let's go take a look and see. So this is my U-shaped bed. And it's here, I'll go from this side of a better angle. So it's 3 feet across. This is 10 feet in on this side, and then it's 18 feet across the back, and then 10 feet over coming down that side. So now he's gonna cut the aluminum siding, and he's gonna put that in once he gets the aluminum siding in. Oh, hi girls. Then we'll fill it up with our dirt, and it'll look just as good as all of those. Oh, I am just so happy to have these arbors up and supports up so that we can actually start planting. We've still got lots of time though.